Hello people, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Aviral and in this video we're going to discuss about the panelization of any PCB. So as you can see, these are all the steps that we're going to discuss. So these are basically the precautions and the margin or the gap between each board or each segment of board, and what are the type of panelization that we can do. So let's open the Altium designer. So guys, I have a great opportunity for you, and if you guys wanna win a $5 coupon right now, what you guys need to do, just go to the description of this video and there you'll find a link, free $5 registration link, and you have to just left click on that link. It will direct you to NextPCB website. There you have to register yourself with your official mail ID and sign up for the NextPCB.com, and there you will find a coupon under my coupon section which will give you a $5 flat discount on your any PCB. So this is the PCB board that we're going to panelize, and as you can see, this is the same STM blue pill board that we have already designed. So if you want to learn how to design this board, you can simply go to the playlist and select from there. So just right click on the project, go to the add new to the project, and left click on PCB. So we have added a board on our project file. Now we'll save that PCB. Just name it PCB underscore panel. So I just want to show you how easy it is to design any PCB panel in Altium Designer. So for that, what you guys need to do, go to the place, left click. Now left click on embedded board array / panelize. And so as you can see, there is a green screen on your keyboard cursor. This is your board or source board. As you can see, you can place it anywhere. Suppose I placed here. Now right click. So as you can see, in the property tab, there is a lot of options, right? So we'll discuss those options one by one. Now we have to select the path or choose the PCB that you need to panelize. So just left click on this browse button, select the PCB. So I'm going to panelize the STM blue pill board. Open. As you can see, the one board is here because the column count and row count is one, right? But before doing anything, we'll just place these parameters or these dimensions for our panelization of board. So if we'll see, the column margin is the gap between the columns. Similarly, row margin is the gap between the row. Row spacing means the dimension of board plus the gap. Similarly, column spacing is the dimension of board and the gap. So what we'll do, we'll go to our PCB board and just press Ctrl M so we can measure the dimensions. Left click, drag your cursor. Now left click, press OK, left click, hold on. So if you like by mistake, if you made wrong dimensions or if you clicked anywhere, so what you can do, you can press Shift and C, so it will remove those dimensions. Now you can press again Control M. And follow the same procedure. Okay. Control M. Okay. So you can see the board dimensions are 53.27 cross 22.98. So go back to your PCB panel. Select the board. Now we'll fill these information. So I always recommend the spacing between columns and rows should be minimum 10 mm because for panelization there is two options, either V grooving or the cutout option. So if you go for cutout, then these gaps should be like 10 mm. If you go for V grooving, then these gap should be around 5 mm minimum. So let's fill these dimensions. So I'm just going to open the calculator. And let's fill the a spacing first. So for row spacing, we'll use this dimension, which is 22.98 plus 10 mm. 22.98 plus 10 is equal to 32.98. Go to the PCB panel and fill here 32.98 mm. Enter. Now we'll going to place the column spacing. So again, go back to your PCB and measure the dimension. Control M. It was around 53. Let's see again. 53.27. Go back to PCB panel. So it will be 63.27. Enter. Sorry, it is in mm. Enter. Now fill the row spacing, sorry, the column margin 10 mm and the row margin also 10 mm, right? So the next step is select the number of rows and columns. So I'm just going to panelize this for 6 boards. So that means it will be 3 columns and 2 rows. Enter. And here you can see your boards are here. Now what we'll do, we'll just adjust the board size. Before that, I'm going to adjust the grid. So go for 1 mm. Now edit, origin, set, and always this point as the origin. So I can't able to select it. Grid, 1 mil. And just select this point. So this is your board dimension. Now press 1 on your keyboard. So I'm just going to adjust the board size. Design, edit board shape. So all the dimensions are in mil here. So I'll go for press Q on your keyboard and it will be in mm. Again, design, edit board shape, it should be five mm from the board. Yeah, it's around 5, right? Similarly, we'll do the same thing here. In this direction also. And here also. Right. Now press 2 on your keyboard. Again, so we generally do panelization plus the component placement together, right? So I mean, we always send our panelized board to assembly house. So for mass assembly, they needed multiple holes on each corner. So for that, what we'll do, we'll just right click here and select via, place it here. Now change its dimension. So its diameter should be around 6 mm and hole will be 3 mm, or you can just decrease the diameter to 4 or 5 minimum. Place it here. Now control C, place here. Control V. Control V. So they can hold this particular PCB under the machine. Control V. So we have to adjust the board size here. Similarly, Control V. So I'm just going to press 1 again. Design, edit board shape, to right. Now you have two options. Either you can go for the V-grooving or you can go for the cutouts. So for V-grooving, what I will do, we'll just go to the mechanical one layer and place V-grooving. So before that, I'm just going to press change the grid to 1 mm. So still I'm on mechanical layer and place a line which should be closer to your board. Again, do the same thing for this. Again, so V grooving is like from where you just want to cut your board. Yeah. Same thing you can do here. Right. Now place V grooving. So here this hole is very close to this board. So again, I'll adjust the board size. Again, please go to the mechanical layer, mechanical one, and place V grooving. Similarly, you have to do the V grooving in Y direction. Like this. Like this. Now, you have to do the same thing here also. I'll adjust the board side again, so the V grooving will be perfect. So in one word, we can say we have to just make the matrix under which we can place our board, like this, right? So now I'll adjust the board size, design, edit board shape. Just make it a little bigger, so we don't need to adjust it again. This is enough. Place holes here. Okay, we forgot we grooving in this direction. So again, we place a line here also. So I'm just showing you how you can place the V grooving. Now select the string, rotate it by 90 degree. Just write V groove. Now Control C. Select it and place it on each corner. So this line is already selected. Now select these lines also. Like this. That's it. So your panelization of PCB with V grooving is done, and you can just directly generate the Gerber file and send it to manufacturer. And like on their website, there can be option for V grooving layer. So you can select the mechanical one. If it is not there, then you have to add the instructions to your manufacturer, and so they can place the V grooving. Okay. So this is one option. now I'm going to go to the single layer, and I'm going to remove all these. Hold on. Tab. Okay. Now delete. Select this also. Delete. Delete. And I'm going to show you how you can do panelization using the board cutout. So again, go to the full view. So for board cutout, again I'll use the mechanical one layer, and just place board cutout. So firstly, I'm just going to use two parallel layer. So that depends on the drill size that we're going to use for the cutout. Now I'll place the arc. Change the grid size. Rotate it by 90 degrees using spacebar. Like this. Now Control C and place here also. Like this. Now I'm going to copy this whole thing. Press Tab, Control C, and make this at the center. Control V, place it here. Here. This should be closer to PCB board. Similarly here, or you can place a big cutout here, but this is risky because like during assembly your PCB can flex, so I always use multiple board cutouts. So I'm just placing it like normally or in approx distance. You can just measure the distance and place them accordingly, whatever the length you want. Like this. Similarly, we'll place the mechanical one layer on Y direction. So change the grid to 1 mm. Again, I'm going to copy this size, so the size will be similar. Change the grid. Delete this portion. Copy this line, place it here. Similarly, again, copy this thing, this curve, and so decrease the line length. So we can't cut out the whole section together, otherwise during assembly it will be difficult for them, or you can, or your board can just break. So just follow all the precautions. Press Tab, Control C, Control V, here, again, Control V, here, Control V, here. Similarly, you can place it here. Have to place it in this direction also. it is not that much difficult, right? So always use like a proper dimensions. I'm just placing it randomly, but you can use dimensions like this. Now you have to place, so as you can see right now, all the PCB board is connected, right? There's no cutout on PCB board, or I'm just going to hide the 3D component. So just left click on this thing, view option, and turn off the 3D parts. Now again, press 2, select this tab, go to the tool, convert, and just click on create board cutout from selective primitive, and left click. That's it. So as you can see, now there is a board cutout, right? So we're going to place this similar board cutout on everything. So just follow the same procedure. I'm just going to tell you one more time. Now, so you have to select the line, tab, go to the tool, convert, and click on create board cutout from selective primitive. Now it will ask for approx cutout and recess, right? So I'm just going to do it for every section of the board. Here we go. So we have made all the board cutouts. Now again, I'm going to press Shift S, and as you can see, our board, panelized board, is ready. If you press 3, so you can see the 3D view of your panelized board. So generally, I'll recommend just try to make this drill bit size a little bit thinner, so your board will be like more strengthened, so that will be easy during the manufacturing, during the assembly of the component. So here we go, guys. You can generate the gerber and send it to your manufacturer. Thank you so much.